This is a mellow.
Yeah. Oh. Whoa. Oh. Yeah. Oh. Ah. Oh.
Bullshit.
Oh. Oh. Wow. Ah.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Oh, baby.
Baby. Let's fuck.
What's good? It's your boy Hargrovevidz coming back with another video. So today's video, we reacting to one of Mr. and the only Coyote Peterson, Brave Wildness. This video is called Spider Murdering Wasp.
You what?
10 things you probably need to know. Now, we're already talking about for the past week about murder hornets when they're actually called giant Asian hornets.
Bruh, shut your bitch ass up!
Killing the bees, the so-called bees in the United States. They don't know a defensive plan yet because every other country live with these bees. I mean, live with these hornets, so they have a defense system. They naturally adapted to those wasps or hornets, whatever. Another reason that I think they call them killer hornets because this hornet came from Asia, and there's speculations that the coronavirus came from Asia. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but that's just what I think. I really think that they call it that name because they're trying to scare people to stay inside because of the coronavirus, stuff like that. And it's a good strategy, man. Just telling them that if it stings you one time, you're dead, and it just keeps people inside. So, you know, maybe it works, but that's not real, you guys. That can't sting you one time and kill you, depending on your body. So if you're allergic to them, which I highly doubt that y'all are allergic to them, one sting will not hurt you or kill you. It will hurt, but it won't kill you like people think they will. And it's just so many stupid people that really believe that they can kill you. Like, now, if you get swarmed, by anything, you're dead. But I'm just saying, there's one, don't act like, oh, I'm stung, I'm gonna die. No, but you just going, your hand gonna be swole. Whatever you got stung by is gonna be swole. So make sure you like and subscribe to this video, man. Hit that red thing at the bottom, and let's get straight to the video, man. Let's get it, let's go. No cap. Ew. He brave because I wouldn't do it.
That is the most intense pain I've ever felt.
Now they're called murder hornet, murder wasp.
Mr. Peterson, we have more breaking news, sir.
Roll action.
Spider murdering wasps? This isn't breaking news. We've had spider murdering wasps in the United States since the early settlers first set foot on the eastern coast of North America. But it is probably something we should talk about. Good evening. Welcome to the Brave Wilderness News Network. I'm your host, Coyote Peterson. And this is 10 things that you probably need to know about spider murdering wasps. Number one.
They ugly.
What is a tarantula? Well, that's a great question.
They ugly.
It's actually the largest species of spider wasp in the United States.
Look at it, bro. You hear that? You hear it, bro?
I can't. Species. They range on almost every continent.
I can't stand that buzzing sound in my ear, but can't y'all stand it? Y'all can't stand it, right? The bzzz. You can't stand that, can you? No, I can't stand it either.
Except for Antarctica, and yes, they definitely target spiders. So, if you have arachnophobia, this creature should actually be your new favorite animal. Number two, How big are they as compared to
each other? Oh, they big as a mother.
Well, the tarantula hawk measures about 2 inches in length, with a wingspan of somewhere between 3.5 and 4 inches, making it the largest wasp species in the entire
country. You hear it, bro?
Now, just because it's that big doesn't mean that it's super fast. And while it is not quite as robust as the giant hornet, once it lands on the ground, it is quite agile. They rely on that speed to outmaneuver the spiders that they're specifically trying to murder. Number three, have they always been here, or are they invasive? Well, unlike the Asian giant hornet, aka murder hornets, spider wasps are native to the United States. In fact, the tarantula hawk inhabits the Southwest. It can be found in Arizona, New Mexico, Nevada, Texas, and even Southern California.
Oh,
watch
no.
out, Hollywood. There's actually a good chance you've seen a spider wasp before. They have an aposematic coloration, which warns you that they are venomous, but they actually kind of look a lot like hummingbirds, and there's a good chance you may have mistaken these wasps for those teeny tiny birds. Number four, do they really murder spiders and
yes,
even
nigga.
Tarantulas?
That's why they got it
yes,
in the name.
They do. And here's the thing. They don't just murder spiders,
they
literally take them hostage. What a tarantula hawk will do is identify a tarantula's burrow, swoop down, and begin to pitter-patter its feet around the opening. This will draw the tarantula out, thinking that, oh my gosh, maybe there's something there for me to eat. Little does that tarantula know, it's about to run into its worst nightmare.
Exactly.
And what the tarantula hawk will do is outmaneuver the tarantula, swoop up underneath it, and inflict a sting. That sting has a venom so potent that it paralyzes the tarantula. Once the tarantula is in a state of paralysis, and this is where it gets horrific, the tarantula hawk drags the tarantula back down into its own burrow and lays a single egg on top of the paralyzed spider. That egg eventually hatches, and the larva burrows down into the spider and eats it while it is still alive. That larva pupates, eventually hatches, and then grows straight out of the tarantula like an alien, turns into a wasp, and then the cycle repeats itself. So if you thought the murder hornet was horrifying, just...
Now that's disgusting. Y'all ever seen one of those, like on Vine or something like that, and they got spiders growing out of a dead spider? Like, that's so disgusting, bro. I don't want to see that. I don't want to step on something and then a thousand of them come out. Like, that make me want to just throw every spider I see outside. Like, come on, bro.
Just try being a tarantula that has to go up against a tarantula hawk. Number five. How painful is the sting of this wasp?
Oh, it's painful already.
Let's just take a look.
I bet you a bee sting on your face. Him.
That was one of the worst experiences I have ever been through. And believe it or not, the sting of the tarantula hawk is only the fourth most painful sting in the insect kingdom. It actually ranks below the bullet ant, the Asian giant hornet, and the execution wasp. Now, the good news about the tarantula hawk sting is that the intense pain only lasts for about 5 minutes. After that, you'll experience some secondary swelling and soreness, but other than that, it's really not that bad. Number six, will the tarantula hawk sting humans for no reason?
Yes.
Well, unless your name's Peter Parker, aka Spider-Man, you have absolutely nothing to worry about because spider wasps want nothing to do with humans. However, in the Southwest, humans do frequently encounter tarantula hawks around their swimming pools. Now, the reason for this is the swimming pool is a great source of hydration for these wasps. Their bodies are so lightweight, they will actually come down and land on the surface of the pool to get a drink. Now, if you see one doing this, don't try to catch it, don't try to kill it, and don't try to scoop it up with your pool strainer. This could possibly provoke an attack and thus result in a sting. If you see one taking a drink, simply admire it from a safe distance in both you and the spider wasp will be absolutely.
But what if they fly near you, bro?
Number seven.
Like, they just start flying around you and stuff like that. Like, you get paranoid and scared.
No, they actually do not. Solitary wasps live a singular existence. They do not live in hives or colonies. However, you will occasionally see congregations of these spider wasps on flowering plants. Because
I won't. I'm not saying no.
So a group of them on a flowering plant. I'm over there. Nothing to fear. They're just enjoying the flowers.
Howdy Peterson, you're going to be like, yes, look at this fine specimen. I'm going to be like, no, sir. I'm all the way over there.
That would be a pretty good matchup. Although at the end of the day, I would probably say the giant hornet because of its robust size and its very powerful mandibles. Now, if the tarantula did manage to maneuver and get up underneath the hornet and inflict a sting, it would send it into paralysis and technically win the match. But based on brute strength alone, I would definitely say the hornet.
Look how loud that is.
Number 9.
I can't stand that noise.
Terrified of tarantula hawks this summer.
No.
I would say it is very unlikely that if you live in the Southwest, you're even going to encounter a tarantula hawk. And to be honest, there's a good chance that you've seen one before and just didn't recognize it. Believe it or not, we have been living in harmony with spider wasps since the dawn of mankind. And very few people are stung every single summer. And the good news is, no sting has ever resulted in human death. Number 10.
Exactly.
Did you create this video because the hype of stinging insects is so popular right now? Guilty as charged. Given the buzz surrounding murder hornets, we figured why not remind everyone that they've been living alongside spider-murdering wasps for countless summers on end. The point being is that while these creatures, while creepy-looking and capable of stinging, pose absolutely no threat to humans. And unless you're a spider, you have absolutely nothing to worry about. So there you have it, 10 things that you need to know about spider-murdering wasps. Depending how this video does, we may even have some breaking news on the unstoppable invasion of volcano ants that are looking to destroy your summer picnic. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave. Stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure.
Breaking news! Volcanoes are erupting killer insects that are ants, and Coyote's got ants in his pants.
I don't have any.
That was gay. I'll never do that to another man. That dude gay.
Nigga, you gay. You gay. Y'all niggas are gay. Nigga, you gay. That's gay.
That nigga gay.
He's in my pants! And there's no volcanoes! No.
If you want to learn more about tarantula hawks, make sure to go back and watch my epic, yet clearly painful encounter with this greatly misunderstood.
We done watching that. We done with that. Make sure y'all like and subscribe. It's your boy Hargrovevidz, and I'm out. Peace.